Oh boy.
Rafi's Rambles.
Hola, you amazing artist. So about a month ago, I posted a video about like, are we leaving YouTube? Are we gonna stay with YouTube? And then we decided to just take a hiatus. Essentially, it would be considered a spiritual hiatus where we really allowed ourselves to get grounded because it wasn't just YouTube. Pretty much everything we were doing, from the jewelry to the music to the art to the books to workshops to art shows to relationships to moving to all that stuff. And we really decided that we needed to find our center. One of the things that happens when you start putting your stuff out there, I'm gonna get pushed by inspiration and I'm gonna get, or pulled by inspiration. But a lot of times what happens is that you get pulled by what your brain thinks you should do. Bear with me here because there's something a lot deeper to this that I'm gonna share with you guys. And listen, you guys, I'm being very vulnerable with you right now on this public platform. I'm sure that you guys have experienced this where you look at your life and you're like, why am I so stressed out? Or like, I should be really happy right now and I'm not feeling happy. Or you look at your life and you're like, how did I end up here? This is not what I expected out of life. We are living the life of our dreams. We just bought this beautiful house. I am married to the person that I love. I get to create for a living. I'm doing videos and have an awesome group of rogues online that like follow us and follow what we do. My life is awesome. I've got books out there. I've live a creative life and I'm very happy with my creative life. However, I wanna say that when you start getting pulled in those directions, right, where you're like, yeah, you know what, this makes sense, maybe I should do this, or this makes sense, maybe I should do this, or maybe I should look at this in this certain way and this is why I do this, you start getting into places where you're like, yeah, you know what, I need to do this, I should do this, this is how it is, this is why I got this popularity, or this is why I'm selling art. Start to add the bars to your own cage, right? Because you're trying to make sense of things. You're trying to make sense of the world. You're trying to make sense of things. So what ended up happening was there was the realization that there was something a little bit deeper to my need to work hard. Let me explain that. So what was going on basically before we took our hiatus was that every single day, Monday through Sunday, Klee and I were both busy with something. It had to do either with art, with jewelry, with YouTube, with the books, with the music, with something like that, right? And that's great. That's great because, you know, it's a lot of creativity, a lot of stuff. What happened over the years was that we just kept adding more things to our plate and not giving us enough time to like actually enjoy life. Actually, like, you know, we just moved to this great area. For the longest time, we couldn't like go anywhere because we just had too much to do. For the most part, the things that we do, it's pretty easy. I get into studio and I create stuff, or I record this video, and a lot of times I don't even have a script. I'm just talking to you right now. Or we're working on music. It's all fun, beautiful things that we're doing. As we started gaining popularity, and I can't speak for Klee, I'm just speaking for myself. As I started gaining popularity with my artwork, with YouTube, with my books, with different things like that, being invited to speak at places, something happened inside of me where my self-worth got tied up to all these things. The purity of the matter is like, I want to share these things, right? I have something to say. I want to share these things. So I'm going to share a video, or I have something to say. I'm going to share it in my book. I'm going to share these things because I have something to say and I want to make an impact on the world. I want people to be happier. I want people to be more empowered. I'm a human being that does art and writes books and does all these things because I have something to say. There's something that I want to put out into the world with this little bit of time that I have left. What I didn't account for was that the more popular that I got with my artwork, the more popular that we got on YouTube, the more popular that other things became, the more that my self-worth got really tied into those things. And in this roller coaster ride, my logical mind kept saying, you gotta work harder. I basically stopped anything that had anything to do with anything other than just working. Because my self-worth was tied into these things, then I was just filling in the gaps and working harder. I associated hard work. You gotta work harder. You gotta fill in the space. You gotta keep doing this. You gotta keep hustling. It made me feel like I was being proactive and doing something. Taking time off and sitting on our front porch and having a beer and enjoying life, or just really engaging in conversation and you know, just the stuff of life, the stuff that it's at the end of every single video. It's like we are inspired by the stuff of life. And yes, the artwork and the writing of the books and all that stuff, that's part of life too. It doesn't mean that it's not. However, if one of those things is dominating all of your time because you have secretly convinced yourself, right, even unbeknownst to yourself, that the reason that you are working so hard is because you have to prove to yourself that you are worth it. Because you work so hard, then you deserve good things. This is something that I was aware of, and in fact, it's something that I've spoken about before, but I don't think I realized how it had snuck into everything that I was doing. These kind of things, they do sneak in there, and that's the reason that the motivation under why you do what you do, right? And it's the reason that I say don't chase the money. Pay attention to what that motivation is underneath the thing that you're doing, right? If you're doing YouTube videos, why are you doing YouTube videos? What are you getting out of this that doesn't rely on validation or doesn't rely on that? What are you getting out of that? If you're doing artwork, what are you getting out of the artwork? You didn't start creating art because you were thinking that you were gonna make money with it. Why are you creating that thing? Why are you putting it out there, most importantly? Are you putting it out there because you want that sense of validation, or are you putting it out there because this is something that I have to give to the world? And that's the truth. When your motivation gets tied up in, instead of you giving to the world, it's all about getting and getting and getting and getting. How many views am I getting? How many likes am I getting? How much money am I getting? How much of this am I getting? And let's be honest, the world kind of revolves around this whole getting thing. No wonder people are always feeling burned out, tired, exhausted. This is one of those things that I'm almost ashamed to share with you guys, is that at some point, even though I felt that I was giving and giving, a lot of my motivation underneath came from desperation, came from being in survival mode, and it caused a lot of frustration, it caused a lot of hurt, it caused a lot of burnout, it caused a lot of the negative stuff that I've been experiencing came because I was in that survival mentality, in that place of desperation, in that place of wanting the validation. That's not the reason that I started this YouTube channel. It's not the reason that I started doing art. It's not the reason that I wrote a book. None of that stuff was the reason that I've created what I've created. And with that information, like, we've thought about stuff, and really it's like just getting back to the core of what it is that I enjoy about doing these videos, what it is that I enjoy about the art, what is it that I actually feel that I'm giving. Really take a look at all that stuff that you keep adding, all that work that you keep adding on your plate because you think that it's going to get you something. It's gonna get you somewhere, versus really focusing on what it is that you're giving. And I know that a lot of you guys are gonna look at this and be like, oh God, here we go. You're gonna talk about giving instead of, like, our entire career, the way that it started, was all about what could we give? What is it that I have kept myself small, that I've been afraid to face criticism for? What am I willing to put out there and be judged for it? What am I willing to put out there and be criticized for it? My authenticity, what really matters to me, the things that I wanna talk about, the things that I really, really wanna share with people, the things that I wanna give. We create amazing stuff. We're artists. This is what we do. We create stuff. Of course we have so much to give. It changes your focus. And instead of constantly being in this rat race where you're chasing something, where you're chasing a buck or chasing this or chasing validation or chasing acknowledgement that you exist, and being willing to create and just give those things to yourself, give yourself the acknowledgement, the validation, the love that you need, and just share stuff because that's what you want to give to the world. That's what you want to share. And it doesn't lead to burnout. It's not a rat race. It's just giving. Yeah, I allowed my focus to go from one place, one mentality to another. And by doing that, adding a bunch of shit to my plate, causing me to feel like I didn't have enough time, causing me to feel like no matter what I did or no matter what I got, it was just never enough. And then causing me to get really, really blocked as far as, like, who it is and who authentically I am and how it is that I want to put myself out into the world. If you're feeling any kind of burnout or anything like that, that means that you've separated yourself from your authentic self because you are trying to be something that you think you need to be in order to get more out of life. So yeah, so that's it. I don't know if that explains anything. I just wanted to share what it is that we've been really going through and thinking about and the things that are important to us, especially when it comes to YouTube, because we haven't been on here for a while. We're still figuring some things out, but I think we're ready to get back to doing some videos, and I'm not sure what that's going to look like, but you know, it is what it is. And yeah, hopefully you guys got something out of this, and yeah, I adore you guys, and I will talk to you later. Adios. Awesome day.